the quarterbacks right now. So we will begin with Cody Kessler and Brock Osweiler.
As a competitor, you always have to go on the mindset of you know, being the starter, you know, at any position. But at the same time, you know, you're still learning from those guys around you. But we come out here and compete every day. You know, me, Kevin, Brock, Deshaun. It's fun when you have guys that are, you know, really talented at that position you get to compete against, because it makes you better as a player. But even if, like I said last year as a rookie, you know, even if you're not or doesn't work out that way, you still got to prepare as a starter. You know, every single practice, every single meeting, even the games.
I've been in the league a little bit longer than the other guys, but at the end of the day, that means nothing. Every quarterback that's in that room is very talented, very smart. I think every single buddy in there works extremely hard, trying to perfect their craft, trying to clean up little things every single day. So there's no edge, not an edge, nothing like that. Everybody has their strengths, has their weaknesses, and I think it's going to be a great competition.
So there they are, Cody Kessler, Brock Osweiler, saying all the right things. Now let's go to the rookie, Deshaun Kizer. And there are two ways of thinking in football and certainly in the NFL. When you get a rookie quarterback, you let him watch and learn for as long as he possibly can, and then you ease him into the lineup. But the new thinking in the NFL is you draft him high, you play him, you put him out there. Now, I think I know where you line up. You line up with the old time, let him wait. It's like a fine wine with you.
Well, I don't know how long
you
can
serve it before it's time.
I'll take it any time. Now, you have to win games, okay? If you have ideally, the quarterback you choose is winning a few games, and there's no rush. But I thought that was the beauty of getting Kizer where they got him, is that you don't feel that internal pressure to get him in there. Not like he was your first or second pick. He was your fourth pick. But it's also incumbent on the guy ahead of him to show some winning performance.
Matt, they seem to be very happy with Kizer. They seem on one day he does this, and on the next day he does that even better than he did it from the day before. So where do you line up on the overall thinking?
I kind of coincide with what Tony. I'm not, you know, new school, meaning thrust him out there, and I'm not, and I want this guy to earn it. But ultimately, I believe for the Cleveland Browns in this franchise to go from 1-15 and take the incremental step that we all believe them to take, which is 4 more wins, 5 more wins, and get more competitive, we need whichever quarterback gives us the best chance to win. If over the course of those 10 days that Tony talked about, Deshaun Kizer proves to be consistent, that the guys trust in him, that we can run the football very well with that offensive line, they can protect him, then you go with him, but he's got to earn it. And I think right now, Brock Osweiler's the consistent. We know what Cody Kessler is. And Deshaun Kizer, if he surprises us, both with consistency and his arm strength, he's going to be the one out there.
Well, here's the thing. I mean, he's actually won an NFL game, Osweiler. He's won 13 of them.
And a playoff game, by the way.
That's right. And a playoff game, by the way. You're right about that. An amazing scene yesterday, over an hour after the team had left the field after practice, I was looking out there, and there was Deshaun Kizer with a script in hand going through like he was in the huddle trying to get the verbiage of the play out. Right. And I understand that's a big thing now for a rookie quarterback coming out of these college offensive systems. They're not typically in a huddle.
Yeah, well, he talked about that, how he has to practice communicating the play precisely, and that takes practice for him. He didn't do that at Notre Dame, and it's good that he's putting in the time, but that is a major difference in the college game at Notre Dame and here.
He seems to really put a lot of work in.
He definitely does, and I think that Brock Osweiler spoke about it in his opportunity to speak with the media, as did Cody Kessler, that Deshaun Kizer came in ready. And Hugh Jackson talked about his ability to be able to dive into that playbook and reconstruct and spit out and confidently spit out those plays in the playbook. And guys, what really shows to me is that Deshaun Kizer feels like he needs to be in the mix, and he wants to turn over every stone possible from every brain trust that he might go with, his college coaches, some of the guys outside of the league that are, you know, maybe coaching him up, Tom House, to put him in a situation to do everything he can to make a run at it.